Hi guys, back again with me, Austin from About Heart. Today I'm going to share again on the 16 line. Okay, it is the Hasbro Star Wars The Black Series 6-inch Target exclusive 3-pack Imperial Death Trooper, Captain Cassian Andor, and Sergeant Jyn Erso. Oh boy, what a long name. Okay, it came with a standard Black Series packaging. Remember, this packaging is just bigger than small. It's a 3-pack after all, 6-inch line. My first 3-pack 6-inch line. My. Again, I'm not betraying my preference for the 3/4-inch line, but I keep an open mind for this, you know. Anyway, the artwork is down there. The name all down below, artwork as well. Cassian, Jyn, Death Trooper. Okay, the Black Series up there, it is quite big. The bio at the back, let me try to read some, maybe the trooper first. Imperial Intelligence Specialized Stormtrooper Armor with Dark Omnibus Bodyguards Enforcers, Director Krennic, Advanced Weapon Research Division. Oh, okay. So that's about it. Okay, you can pause if you want to read. Compass Alliance Intelligence Officer. I think same with the 3/4-inch line. I think the same. Complete. Wow, cool head under fire. Complete his mission with minimal resources. Good. Sergeant Jyn Erso, Jedi version. Highly skilled. Defian Warrior. Okay, Jyn Erso. Oh, so she likes to debate. Okay, anyway, that's quite a huge package. Just want to share, I'm going to cover each one by one in each separate videos, because otherwise it will take too much time, because there are a lot of things to cover from these guys. Okay, so without further ado, let's break the figure loose from the packaging and see what they look like close ups. Each one of them. Okay, let's take a look at the helmet first. Of course, that's the actual hat. No hat inside. Kind of miss the old day, you know. But sometimes it is better. It's very much has the same features. Okay, the green, I don't know what's that. Okay, got nice detailing. I think the Google part is kind of greenish now. This part is molded as well, same with the smaller one. Okay. So yeah, but very neat so far. Okay, with nine molded detail here and there. And then it also got this version, got the pauldron here. So I realized that in the 3/4-inch version, the small version, because there's only one release, they actually give us this version. But then in the 6-inch version, if you get the single box, not a single card anyway, it's a single box release, then you only get the Death Trooper, basic Death Trooper without this pauldron. Okay, that's what I just realized, because I wasn't really paying attention to that line, to this line. So it's pretty much the same design as well. I'm not sure what it is, okay, but nicely molded. It is still using rubbery material, okay, and it is removable, the granite here. I assume it's granite. I think everybody is assuming it's granite. I'm not sure what it is really. Okay, we have this as well. At the back, typical trooper, right? Shoulder pads, nice. This is rubbery as well on the, what do you call that, on the belt. Now this belt, it has kind of a sling where you can put your smaller blaster. You know, whereas the smaller one doesn't have it, but I kind of tuck it in into the pauldron, so there's an opening there. But here, no, we don't need that. We have something like this, okay, which is rubbery. I'll show you later. It works wonder. Now let's try to take out the pauldron. Okay, first off, you can pop off this. Okay, So I did try to take off the pauldron. Okay, it's very rubbery. However, basically what you need to do is a bit similar with the smaller version. There's a peg and peg hole there. Okay, just have to take it out just like that. Let me check if there's anything. Okay, that's all, just one peg. And then you can just take it out like this, right? But you need to take off the head, which is I've been trying to do off the video of the record, but I'm not sure why. It is really, really hard. I think I didn't try enough with the hot water treatment or the hydro treatment. So anyway, it's doable. Okay, we know that something is holding it on the helmet, so you can actually easily take it out. I just want to take this moment a little bit to appreciate what's under the we call it pauldron slash armor. Okay, there's a bit of molded detail here and there. See, there's this part, this on the waist. So I think that's the inner clothes supposed to be. I like that they still pay attention to that much of detail. Okay, the belt is actually kind of a separate part, but I don't think you can take it off unless you really pop off all the part on the body. Okay, anyway, it's also rubbery and rubbery. So I'll just put the pauldron and slash harness back. See that there's the peg hole there. Okay, very clear. The peg is there. Okay, see, just here. So what we need to do is we have to connect both, and we're all set. Okay, now the legs. It's kind of thin, sleek, I guess. Molded detail on the knee here. A bit rubbery. It doesn't have it here. Very interesting. I'm not sure why. I think that's the actual design. Okay. Nice, nice detail. It's all glossy. There's a bit of mold detail here as well. And the shoes, it's kind of a matte paint of black with bit of grit there. Okay, bit of details as well down there, nothing much. All right. Okay, so we'll try to do the articulation. The head, when I tried to pop it off, may not be very visible to you, but actually there's in there, it doesn't only have a ball joint, but there's a hinge, okay, to allow you more movement like this. But since the pauldron is attached, we cannot have much more. Okay, that's the extent that we can have to utilize that hinge, which is okay by me. I mean, it's not like you really need it that much. Okay, side to side, not so much. So actually, it's very movable. It's just that the pauldron is kind of hindering the articulation. Anyway, you can still turn it around. It's a ball joint after all. Okay, so that's with the head. The arm is on a ball hinge joint. So let me find the hinge for you. That's the hinge. Okay. Oh, down here is very all the grids, all the part with linings here. How the inner clothes, I believe. So that's the hinge. By adjusting the hinge, you can move. That's the outward extension that we can do with this figure. Let me try to move it to the back. Okay, that's kind of, oh, so I find something that's interesting. That shoulder pad, although it is molded, it is very rubbery. So you can actually do something like this. See? Okay, very interesting. I think it is glued to downward part. So they really thought it through, you know, that it doesn't hinder the articulation. So that's cool. I think that's really cool. I kind of appreciate that now. Okay, clever, clever, I believe. You can also focus, please. Turn it around like this. This one, of course, is a bit hindered by the piece here, but since it's rubbery, you can kind of have your way through. All right. So that's with that part. Okay, you can bend this much the arm. All right. And you can turn it around, I believe, sir. Yes. There's articulation on the wrist, okay, for the palm to rotate, but there's also a hinge there, which allows you to do this up, a bit hindered, I guess, but up and down, down a lot, which is cool because you need this position to help with holding the gun with both hands, okay. Now, what really strikes me is that in the 3/4 inch version, I found that the hinge on the right wrist is not this way. Okay, it's the same with the left one on this 6-inch one, but I prefer it for them to move, you know, this way, instead of this way. You know, I like it this way. You see the hinge is there, but on the 4-inch version, the hinge is actually down there. You got what I mean? See, the hinge is down there, so you can instead do this kind of position, right? This position is really cool, so because by this you can actually do a better sniping position. See, by adjusting this, the gun it seems like, you know, he's really aiming with the gun instead of just holding it. See this bend. Whereas this one, yes, you can still grip with both hands, but it doesn't have that sniping, cool sniping position anymore. It's a bit kind of tricky to do. Okay, it's not impossible, but it's not the best compared to what we have with the smaller version. I prefer the small version hinge, really. Okay, and also, okay. You have crunch on the upper diaphragm. Let me try. That's the front extension. That's the back extension. You can kind of move it side to side as well. It's a ball joint after all. Of course, you can. You're supposed to be able to turn it around. Oh, that's cool. It doesn't hinder it. So that's cool. Yeah, I think that's enough rotation. I wanted to check if there's any more rotation down here, but I don't think it's necessary because anyway you cannot utilize it. Okay, you will utilize this, but I don't think it has it though. Okay, now down here, it may not be very visible because of the, what do you call that, this belt, but it is actually on a ball joint, but then it's not only attached, but they add a little bit more a hole there. Hole there. So this top part is a ball joint. Okay, but I believe there's rotation there as well, which is cool in my opinion. So they added a little bit of movement range here with the hole down there, so you can kind of make this movement. Okay, this kind of split. With it, although to the front is a bit hindered by the belt, but it's okay. So I think that's cool with the top, the upper ways. So I think it's a bit different mechanism than what they have with the smaller version. The smaller version utilize a ball hinge joint on this part, whereas this one is only a ball joint, but with extra holes of extra room for movement. Anyway, it can still do this much of kicking. Of course, it is kind of hindered with the belt there. That's part of a belt, but anyway, it's still able to do open leg position, which is cool enough for me. Now, this rotation up there. Let me try. Okay, so see, yes, you can rotate, I guess, 360. Let me try. Let me try. Dude, okay. It's not that the joint cannot turn 360, but because of the molded part on the thigh, it's very hard to do a full rotation. Nonetheless, you can still do it. Okay, just want to say to you that you can actually do it, but it's not necessary to do that, really. But just want you to know that there's rotation here. That's the gap of the rotation. All right, I hope it's visible because it's all black. Sorry for my black new background. Anyway, it's working, so that's cool. The knee, okay, knee is a double join the knee. Let me try on this side instead. So that's the extension of the knee band, which is cool, I guess. Let me try if there's any join. Oh, you have actually rocker ankle. See, rocker ankle side to side like that. And you also have hinge join. Let me try if there's any rotation. No, only a hinge up, down and upward. Upward is a bit hindered, but downward is really good. But no rotation. Rotation is only up there on the thigh, which is cool. Okay, so I think very interesting. There's a bit of difference with this smaller version, but I think still enough possibility with this guy as well. Okay, now it came with two guns, same with the smaller version as well, but a little bit more detail, just bigger version really. Okay, it's very rubbery but still solid, but you can see that mine is a bit bended. It's still fixable with hot water treatment or hair dryer treatment, so I'll just fix it later. There's a red paint there, the hole with the trigger, I guess. It's very cool. Okay, very similar to this smaller version pretty much. Okay, they stay true to it. I'll try to make a sniping position later on with both hands. Okay, anyway, this is the small blaster, which is solid as well, molded nicely as well. There's a hole there. Okay, I'll try to put it on his right hand because he can. Okay, that right palm is the trigger, the one with the trigger finger. You can actually put the finger in there, so it fits nicely. Okay, I like that. I like working accessories. Cool. Right, now the plus version, the plus feature on the 16th version is that they actually give you a sling to put your small blaster. Okay, so that's the plus on this mode. I'm not sure whether you should put it like this on this direction or this direction. I just try to do it this way because it, anyway, I feel it, that it makes sense more. But anyway, both, I think it works on both position. So you just have to put in, tuck it in into, and you're all set like that. Okay, it holds nicely, really. So that's a good, I think that's good enough. Now let's try to do a sniping position, or maybe shooting position, because you cannot really snipe. See, this is why I prefer the hinge to be down there instead of this on this side, because you cannot put with the hinge down there. You can put the gun, you can hold the trigger finger just right in front of, you know, what do you call that, just in front of his face, so it looks like he's making a sniping position from long range. But then by this joint, it's not that easy to do that, the right positioning on the hinge really matters in this case. Anyway, you can still do shooting position, it's not a sniping position, shooting position with this. Okay, let me show it to you. All right, so you just have to grab here and you have shooting position. Okay, pew pew pew, right, really cool. I like that. Although one thing that really I'm not sure, this part of the pauldron kind of make it weird. Anyway, yes, so he's able to do the shooting position. You just imagine if the hinge is down there, he can do like a cool sniping position. Alright, Imperial Death Trooper, 16th version. Okay, anyhow, he's still able to do a very cool pose like this. Okay, it's really cool. So I love it. Let's scale him up. Let me straighten him up first. Okay. So the top of oopsies, yeah, but that's right. Sorry, the hand is on the way. Okay, so the top of his head is standing about 6 and 6.25, around that, okay, inches tall, I believe so. Okay, around that. Not really good at inches, to be honest with you. We use centimeters here. But anyway, just to recap while I'm putting this. Oh, wait, let me compare with several other figures. 6 inch line, okay? Wait a second. This is K2SO. I've shared this before in my previous video. Formerly the same side. This guy. Okay. Okay, wait, let me adjust the way he stand first so that he can stand better. Come on. Okay. So that's interesting. I think the distribution of the weight is not even. Okay. Now K2SO is taller, it's a given. This is 6 inch comic grid standing up. The camera doesn't even fit him anymore. This is 3A if you happen to have, oh, he's shorter than the trooper. By the way, you can check out 3A figures. They are really cool. If you like weathered look, if you like bigger scale than this, they have it. Oops. Okay, let me try finding some other figures as well. If you want to buy the Han Solo that's going to be released as the 40th anniversary release, and this Chewbacca, which also being released, and Chewbacca is taller than all of them combined. Not combined, I mean even taller than K2SO. So I thought K2 was kind of a bit of same height, but yeah, it's just his head is a bit smaller. All right. Okay, so to recap again a little bit, okay, I like this that trooper. I mean, the 4-inch scale one was a revelation to me. I mean, it gives me hope for this, for the 4-inch line of the 3/4-inch line of Star Wars, because I was kind of losing hope to it. You know, whether they will continue on with it. I mean, seriously. So they do have that capability to do that, and I just hope they will still. But this figure is really cool if you are into 6-inch line. If you want to make a surgeon out of your Death Trooper platoon, okay, if you have the single box Death Trooper, which is really cool. It's just that to take off this pauldron is very hard. I think that can be a good way. I like the sling holster on for the small blaster, something that we didn't have in the 3/4-inch line. Detailings are okay, paintings are okay, I guess. Right. So overall, it's a satisfying figure. It's just that if only they can give, oops, sorry about that. If only they can give a bit different placing for the right hands. Hinge join, then he will be able to do some this kind of pose. See, it's a bit higher on the placement of the gun, which is cool. I think it resembles more as a sniping position than what we have on the 6-inch line. If you're into 4-inch line, I recommend getting this one as well. I really recommend that. It's a cool figure to have for the 4-inch. For 4-inch scale collectors.
Treasure Quarter Inch collectors. Okay, we'll cover on the other figures from the next from this package on the next videos. So thanks guys for watching. I'm Austin from Boy at Heart. Subscribe to the channel, like the video. Goodbye.